So this is a recording for the guess my number exercise, the first coding challenge that I had y'all do. This will walk through both the basic and the advanced steps of the challenge. So if you didn't figure out the entire challenge, maybe go back with this in order to figure some of those things out. I'll also be giving a little bit of background on Python coding in this. So hopefully this will help you if you've been confused on some of the code issues that we've looked at so far. So where do you begin? Well, if you're going to do a guess my number game, then the first thing you need is a random number. This will be the computer's guess. And the way that we find a random number in Python is by using the random library. So we're going to use an import statement. Import random, and this will import the random library. This will allow us to use a whole bunch of handy random functions, and eventually we'll actually use this a lot in game development because there's a lot of times when you want a random choice to be made. In this case, we want a random number between 1 and 9, and so we're going to choose, we're going to create a random number by using the random.randint function. This randint function takes a number, takes two numbers, 1 and then the top range that you want the number to look for, in this case 10, and it will pick a random number and assign it to the variable myNum. So in this function, myNum equals random.randint in parentheses 1 comma 10, 1 being the start, 10 being the end. We're going to get a random integer between 1 and 10. So now we've got that stored in myNum. The next thing we want to do is ask the user for their number. We're also going to print out myNum so that for debugging purposes we know what the computer has chosen so that we can check it against what we have in our own program. So we're going to ask for the user to give us their number. And so for this we're going to use raw input. Now, you'll see this raw input statement, what is your number? This statement will prompt the user for their number. And it'll use the string, what is your number, that we have in these parentheses as the user prompt. Now, the problem with this is that when the user puts something into raw input, it will be automatically stored as a string. And Python doesn't automatically convert types. So if you have a string of 6 stored into this, you're not necessarily going to get you're not going to get the integer 6. So don't mind my email popping up on the right hand side. Sorry about that. So here's the deal. What you need to do is you need to take the user's input and coerce it into another type. In this case, the integer type. And we do this in Python using int and wrapping our raw input function with the int function. This takes what you get from raw input and it turns it into an integer. So when you run this, it'll look like this. The computer's number is the number 3. That's this print line on line 4. And now it's asking me for a number. What is your number? I'm going to put 4. And it just goes back to the prompt because we're not handling that in any way. Now, we're storing this number in user guess, and we're going to make use of that here in the next statement. So now we're going to check whether user guess is equivalent to myNum. And so we're going to use an if statement for that. And we're going to say if user guess equals myNum. Notice the double equal sign, this tests for equivalence. Single equal sign is to assign. So when we say user guess is equivalent to myNum, then we will print out, you got it, nice job. Now we can run that and test it. If I were to put in the number 7, it prints out, you got it, nice job. But what if I put in something other than 7? If I were to put in, say, the number 4, where this is supposed to be 6, it doesn't know what to do with that, so it just falls through and stops the program. So we need something else. So we're going to add a couple of elif statements. We'll add an elif user guess is less than myNum, print too low, and an elif user guess is greater than myNum, print too high. So now if we run our program, And I guess a number that's less than my num, or sorry, that's greater than my num, I get too high. It still falls through because we only are testing for one thing. If I guess something that's less than the number, I get too low. Okay, so now what? Well, this isn't really a very fun game because this only lets you choose once, and it doesn't keep track of your choices or anything like that. So we can add a few other things. The first thing I want to add is an else statement here. Because if there is no equivalence, if, say, the user puts in a letter or something like that, we want our thing to fail gracefully. Actually, no, I'm sorry. That's not what this is for. This is in case there's some other condition that comes in, which in this case really shouldn't happen when we're testing for equivalence and greater than or less than. So this should never be called. We'll deal with failing gracefully in a few minutes. Okay. So the next thing I want to do is to add a couple of turns to my game and to keep the game going if the user doesn't get the number right. And so for this, what I want to do is start by adding a variable. And I want to add the variable game over equals false. What I'm doing here is I'm saying the game's still going. Keep giving responses. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to add a while loop. And what this while loop will do is it will keep running the same commands over and over and over again as long as the condition within the while loop obtains. So while game over is equal to false, then what we're going to want to do is ask for the user's guess and continually evaluate the user's guess. Now, right now as it stands, this will not work. And the reason for this is that Python cares a lot about white space. In most programming languages, you use curly brackets in order to denote blocks of code that are going to be run after a while loop or after an if-else statement or something like that. In Python, you use white space in order to do that. We've already seen the white space at work here in our if and elif statements. So you'll notice that after the if statement ends with a colon, and then after the colon, we go in by one tab. And so what that will do is that says that this is the condition that happens after the user guess is equivalent to my num. And we saw that in action already. So if we want to make all of these statements here from lines 9 to 18 a part of our while loop, what we want to do is indent them all by one level. So we're going to go through and do that. Okay. And so now what we have is a while loop that will continue to ask for the user's guess and just keep running. So I'm going to put in the number. If I put in the number 4, it's going to tell me it's too low and ask me again. Put in the number 6, it tells me it's too high, and it'll ask me again. But what if I put in the number 5? Well, if I put in the number 5, it'll tell me, you got it, nice job, but then it'll ask me again. So we need to do one other thing, and that is to set our flag for game over to take us out of this while loop if the user actually guesses the right number. And so what we're going to do is add game over equals true in our if user guess equals my num statement. What this will do is change game over to true, and then when the while game over equals false is evaluated, it'll evaluate that as false, and so it'll kick us out of this loop. So let's check that for a second. We're going to check 5, it's too high, 2 is too low, but if I check number 4, you got it, nice job, and it kicks us out of the game. So this is enough to actually be an interesting game, but we're going to add a couple of other things to this. So the next thing we're going to add is a counter, because it would be a good idea to praise the user if they get the number in, you know, 3 or fewer guesses. And it would also be a good idea to tell the user that they lost or they're not very good at it if they get the number in 4 or greater guesses, and maybe even stop the game. So I'm going to set my counter to 0, and then we're going to increment this counter every time the while loop goes through its loop. Now we do that by what we're going to do here is we're going to check to see whether the counter is less than 4. So this is going to be a condition of the while loop. We use the and here because we want to make sure that the game is still going on and the counter is less than 4. If we use an or here, then what will end up happening is the game will just never end because of the logic of that statement. So the logic of that statement is really important to figure out. And then we're going to add a counter. And we're going to say counter equals counter plus 1. So every time our while loop goes through the loop, we're going to add 1 to our variable counter. So what this will do is it will kick us out after we get to 4 guesses. Now, what we want to do here is also handle that situation. So if we get to 4 guesses, we want to prompt the user that they lost. If the user gets it in less than 4 guesses, we want to prompt the user that they won. And so we do that with an if-elif statement. So if the counter is greater than or equal to 4, then we print you lost. If the counter is less than 4, we print you win. And actually, this should be an elif statement. Elif the counter is less than 4, print you win. Now, we can do a lot of other things with our program. First, let me show you this, and we'll test this. We're going to say, I'm going to say 1, it's too low, 2's too low, 5's too low, 6 is, or it's too high. And then since I was at 4 guesses, I lost. Now let's say my number is 2, my number is 1. Oh, I got it. I won. Okay, so we're keeping track of how many guesses, and we're labeling a win condition here, which is great. Now, in order to make the game fun, we probably should take out this print statement in line 4 because we don't really want to tell the user what the number is that they're looking for. And we can do a lot of other things with this. You know, we could add in something that tells the user how many tries it took them. We could also add in a little bit of error correction to deal with what happens if the user puts in something that's not an integer into their raw input. But a lot of those things are other functions that we can learn at other times, and we'll play around with those functions as we go on in this course. But for right now, this does a pretty good job, and this does what we wanted it to do. So I hope this was helpful. If you have other questions, ask them in the forums, and have a good week.